This is Dragons Live, presented by Form Communications.
Hello, everyone at home watching the Dragons play in today's Mineral Water Bowl. We are live right now, believe it or not, from Excelsior Springs, Missouri. And it was a little sunny. Now the clouds have rolled back in. The lights are on. The footballs are flying here as the Dragons prepare to take on Missouri S&T in today's Mineral Water Bowl. Thank you all for joining us at home at Buffalo Wild Wings. I hope you're there watching. We are here inside the press box. I'm joined here by Dragonfire president and 2007 football alum, Matt Oakes. Matt, we're here to have some fun. What was the trip like for you today to get to this point?
Well, it was a lot of fun. We came down on Thursday, spent some time, did some socials with Dragonfire, and we've just been kind of hanging out, getting a lay of the land and doing some sightseeing.
Now, we had a golf tournament planned. As you can see, there's a little bit of snow still on the sides of the field today, and they were struggling to get the field cleared, so the golf tournament apparently didn't happen. There are a bunch of events, the viewing party, as we mentioned, back home at Buffalo Wild Wings. Just a lot of things that Dragonfire helps do. What does a game like this mean for you as an alum and as president of Dragonfire?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun to be able to get together with a lot of your old teammates. Everybody with Dragonfire supports all Dragon athletics, but you know, to have events like this really is just exciting. Brings everybody together and kind of builds that community together.
And you know, we talked about that community, and a lot of people are here. A lot of people are watching at home. You know, what's your message to them sitting at home today as they watch today's live football coverage?
Cheer loud.
Cheer loud. You heard it from the man himself, Matt Oakes. Max, thank you for joining us today. Right now, we're going to talk a little bit about a tradition that started here with the Dragons football program and Steve Lockway, the Box Talks. Take a look.
You know, the Box started when we first got to the program, and it was a way for us to, as coaches and players, be able to talk in front of the team, open up a little bit.
Each senior, you know, gets an opportunity to speak to the team as a whole the Friday night before one of the football games his senior year.
That's everyone that's played here, and there when they're seniors, they tell us a little story about how they came here, what Dragon football means to them, and they put something in there, and that's like just something that we play for, we all play for. We know everyone that's put something in that box has put a Dragon uniform on, and we wear them on their backs too, just like we play for them, we play for our buddies.
For us, it was a way at the beginning to build some teamwork, to build some bonds within each other. I think as it's evolved through the program, it's really been about the lessons and the legacy that each senior is able to pass on to the guys beneath them, and then it really, I think, helps reinforce the fact that we're all part of something bigger than ourselves.
I was looking forward since my freshman year to have my box talk, because I've heard some great box talks from some guys, some funny box talks, but I think it just, you know, it helps you understand, like, this is a family. It's not just a team, it's a family.
The box got pretty full, and I spoke with Coach Lockway about my box talk item being a new box, big enough to put the old box into, to symbolize kind of, you know, here's a lot of players that got us to this point, but now it's time to turn the page and, you know, become a different program, a winning program.
The box kind of resembles the family. I perceive it that way. People who put stuff into there put in their, you know, their legacy. But when you're able to look at that, you're able to look at, well, my short 4 years here resembles a much bigger picture because of what they had put in the box. You get people who are still excited about our wins. I mean, after the Bemidji and St. Cloud games, you get people reaching out saying congratulations to, you haven't heard their names in forever, but they don't forget. And I think there are silent cheerleaders, and there are cheerleaders who just know that it's much bigger than just us. I mean, they felt the victories too, and kind of think that keeps us all one big family at the end of the day.
I think it's a constant reminder of being part of something bigger than yourself, the legacy that this program has been building. And you got to draw upon that when times get difficult, and that's why it's on the sideline to remind us that, you know what, there's people before us that have done difficult things. They believe in us, they're behind us, and it's time for us to get it done when the going gets tough.
Hello everyone, and back to Excelsior Springs, Missouri for Dragons Live coverage of the Mineral Water Bowl. We are going to be right back. You see the box out there that they were just talking about. It's another day and another opportunity to add to the Dragon football story, and we'll be back with more right after this.
Do more of what you love without being held back by joint pain. At Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, our team will work with you to create a care plan that meets you where you are, choosing treatment options that fit your lifestyle, so you can get back to more outdoor adventures, more traditions, more active moments, more you. See how you can reach your more at Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Okay, one more.
All right, Benji.
Come on.
Benji.
Yes, smile.
Come on, what Benji. About the flash?
Okay, one more.
Benjamin, hold it
sideways. Make a flash, Benji. You have to back it up. You want to get everybody in. You can't get everybody in unless you back up.
Well, he did.
There you go.
Did you get it? Do you need me?
Don't forget to take home with my camera.
I think you got it. Benjamin.
Take another shot.
I think I blinked.
Buffalo Wild Wings. Wayne's Beer Sports.
Welcome back again to live Dragons Live coverage on WDAY Extra and the Dragons Live Network of the Mineral Water Bowl, MSUM Dragons against Missouri S&T. And we've got another special guest here in the press box with us, Amy Ruley, who has recently joined the Dragons team in a development and alumni standpoint from their Alumni Foundation. So I've heard you had a little history here in the past with this game. Tell us about it.
Well, history in the state of Missouri with as Division II with women's basketball. We were at Central Missouri and played the Jennies with some success. And then our first D2 National Championship in 91 was at Southeast Missouri. So we've had some good success as a Bison across the river, and really exciting and happy to be here with the Dragons today.
Well, you're going to be our good luck charm today then, because you've got so much successful history here. But a lot took... It took a lot to get to this successful moment, and a lot of support of our alums and our foundation and our donors. Tell us about that support and what continued support means to help Dragon football and all of Dragon athletics and all of MSUM keep making giant steps forward.
Well, you're right, John, and I think for me to come to MSUM, it started with our president, Dr. Blackhurst, who I think has put a great team
together. She's pretty cool.
She's pretty cool.
She's in here with us.
You'll get the we bring the big hitter at the end here. But to see what's in place now, and really, you look at the success of this football program, and it's the parallels the growth in our scholarships. And so it's exciting to know we have a lot of pieces in place, and with the donor support, which is much of what I saw in my time at NDSU, you know, we really grew that program as a Division II powerhouse through the support of businesses, alumni, people who wanted to see the program be successful. And that's where we are with the Dragons. We just need more financial support, more opportunities to bring in more quality student athletes, which we've shown they are outstanding, and then to upgrade our facilities, much like we were able to do over at NDSU. So it's always an exciting time to be a Dragon for our alumni. I'm happy and excited, and the future is so bright. We just need to continue to get that financial support.
And you've been mixing it up with our fans and alums and parents and everybody who's here. How fired up are they for today?
You know, it's so exciting, and to see the tears in the eyes of the parents, and having followed their sons through this opportunity, it's really fun. And to know that we're making big leaps, you know, it comes through those baby steps, but big leaps to take the program forward. And again, if we can get the scholarship support to the level that's allowed, that 36 scholarships that the NCAA allows at the Division II level, I really don't see any reason we can't be national champions. And I've said that was the exciting thing to come here. I just feel we have everything in place. We're in a great community. We have an outstanding university, great leadership. We just need more financial support.
Well, with your help, we can make that happen. Thank you for joining us, Amy. We appreciate your time. And we just talked about the impact that you can have and have had on growing Dragon football, Dragon athletics, and MSUM. Here's what the Dragon football and their impact had on some of our student athletes and alums.
Why did I come to MSUM? Really didn't know what I wanted to do after college, and as soon as Coach Murph started recruiting my best friend and I from high school, we kind of made the decision to come up here together. And you know, he might not be here anymore, but I'm glad I stuck it through because I kind of needed him for that first year to be able to last all 5 years.
I chose to come to MSUM because of the family atmosphere that our football team has here. Coaches are awesome, and the guys are great to hang around with, and in general, it's just a great group of guys.
I started talking to MSUM about my junior year of high school, and after that, I pretty much didn't really show much interest in any other college. They just showed an interest, like they weren't trying to sell you. They actually cared about you and your life and your family and all the different goals that you had. So it was just nice. And then when I went on my official visit, everything just proved to be real even more. So
coming into the program, you know, I didn't know what to expect almost. I knew who the coaches were and what they stood for, but I did not think that I would have so much growth just as a person and a player throughout the 4 years I've been here.
It's helped me learn to deal with difficult times and always have a find a way attitude. I think that's kind of the number one thing that's always stuck with me out of everything is no matter what I do in life, you know, whether it's the ups, the downs, whatever is, I'll always be able to find a way.
You don't necessarily play it for the wins and losses, which are important, but you play it for the relationships that go deeper than anybody sees. And I think that's why people that play this game are so tied to each other when everything's done. And when you see your guys buy into that and know that they're forging lifelong relationships that are gonna not end after this last game in Missouri, but they're gonna continue on and those memories are gonna be there and that support is gonna be there year in and year out, because these guys are gonna face tough times in their life, but they know that they're gonna be able to count on these guys that they played football with and develop this special and deep bond with this season. And I think when you witness that as a coach and you know that your players have that moving forward into this difficult life, I think you look at it and go, you know what, we did a good thing here. We prepared them for the game of life and for the adversity that life is going to throw at them.
Stick with us here on Dragons Live. Pre-game coverage of the Mineral Water Bowl here in Excelsior Springs, Missouri. As you see out there, the Dragon faithful who have made it all the way down. We will be right back after a short break with President Ann Blackhurst. Stay tuned. Update or download to the all-new MSUM Dragons app on iTunes and Google Play. The new app features customized following of only your favorite Dragons teams, incredible in-app live stats and media coverage, and our Fired Up Rewards program all in one easy-to-use app. Update your Dragons app, search MSUM in your app store, or visit MSUMDragons.com/app to download the new MSUM Dragons app today.
What does digging deeper look like? Missouri University of Science and Technology.
Welcome back to Dragons Live pregame show here from Excelsior Springs, Missouri. It is a little chilly, but still above 40 degrees, not probably as cold as it is back home. But we are here. We're about to watch the Dragons take on Missouri S&T as we welcome you back inside the press box here at Tiger Stadium. And I am joined here by MSUM President Dr. Ann Blackhurst. Thank you for joining us. And I know your journey down here was long, as it was for all of us, but you got to be a part of a special banquet last night. Tell me a little bit about that and what that was like.
Thanks, John. I did get to go to the pregame banquet last night, and it was actually, it was awesome. You know, what I was struck by most is how many similarities there are between the two teams. For both of us, it's been a long time since we have played in postseason play in a bowl game. We both had extraordinary seasons, maybe outperformed everyone's expectations, except, of course, for our own.
Of course.
And both teams are extraordinarily grateful to the family and fans who have supported them not only this year, but during some lean years as well. And so it was really an opportunity to come together and reflect on all of that. Certainly today we will be fierce competitors, but last night we had a moment where we reflected on what bonds we share and what binds us together as football programs.
Well, let's continue to reflect a little bit more on this whole situation. Has been a fun, fun ride, and it all accumulates today to a football game, a bowl game. But what does this mean long term for MSUM, our students, student athletes, our community?
You know, it means so much. Every president wants their school to win, and of course I'm rooting for the Dragons today. But win or lose today, I'm just so incredibly proud of our team for the season they've had, for all the work that went into bringing us here today, and for the fact that we have done it, in my view, the right way. We've done it with character and hard work and dedication, with grit, humility, and heart. You know, on paper, we probably shouldn't have an 8-3, hopefully a 9-3 season. You know, we're not the most highly resourced program. We don't have the most scholarships. We don't have the fanciest facilities. But we have a team culture that is all about finding a way. And I'm just so proud of our athletes and the way they conduct themselves on and off the field. And I think that same pride is what is felt by our entire community, not just the Dragon community, but the Fargo-Moorhead community and beyond. And we can all really bask in that pride today.
Well, we're excited to watch football. Thank you for joining us. Any one last message to anybody watching at home?
Go Dragons.
That's right. Go Dragons. We'll be right back with more pregame coverage right after a short break.
Exceeding expectations. Getting better every day. It doesn't happen by chance. Preparation pays off. So the only question to ask yourself is, am I better today than I was yesterday? Exceed yesterday. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
We've got more Dragons Live pregame show from the Mineral Water Bowl, but first we're going to talk to Coach Fenwick of Missouri S&T. Joined here by head coach of Missouri S&T, Coach Fenwick. It has been a long preparation for today, the Mineral Water Bowl here in Excelsior Springs. What does it mean for your program and your school and your community to play in a game like today?
Yeah, it's been pretty exciting. I mean, it's been a long time since we've been to the postseason, 1950. And, you know, just the anticipation, you know, going 9-2 and just kind of hoping we're going to get something. And then getting the call that we're going to be able to, you know, play in a bowl game and play in the Mineral Water Bowl. Our kids are pretty fired up. They're excited to just get a chance to put the pads on together one more time and play a good team. I mean, it'll be a challenging game. But the community's fired up. There's been a lot of emails and phone calls from alums. And so it brings a lot of excitement to the football program.
And it was an exciting time period, but it was a long one. Between your last game and today, what has preparation been like for you and your team?
Yeah, it's you got that week where you just find out, and then you got to kind of prepare. So we kind of backed off a little bit, tried to get us healthy. We got them in the weight room, but then just really spent time in preparation just as a staff. And then we went, we got 3 days of practice before Thanksgiving break, and then we brought them back on Sunday after Thanksgiving break, and kind of that, you know, it was getting after it. You know, going through that, you find out and you're excited, and then you go to practice and it's like, oh, we're still practicing. And then you get to the next day and it's, you know, you realize, man, that game is so far, it feels like it's so far away that it's almost like spring practice. You're not really getting ready for something that you can see right in front of you. So that was something that we had to, you know, make sure that our kids understood that it's going to be here before we know it. And then the break was good. I thought it was just good to get those guys away and see their families. And then we, like I said, we came back on Sunday and just then it was like, okay, it's we're a week away. It's game week. And we had some really good, crisp, focused practices through the week. And then just coming down here and just kind of going through all the events, the dinners and the banquet and all that stuff. It's just great experience. But now, you know, you wake up and it's time to go and it's time to play, and you put all that other stuff aside and you remember, okay, this is why we're here. So
it's good.
And we are here, and that long wait is over.
Yeah.
What is it going to take for S&T to get the win today?
Yeah. Well, I think, you know, looking at Moorhead on film, I mean, they're physical, and the conference is physical. And you know, I've been a part of that conference, and I've played against teams in the playoffs, you know, in the Duluths, the Mankatos, and, you know, I just know how that league plays. And I think, you know, for us, you know, we're going to have to match that physicality and make sure that, you know, we're able to stop the run, get after the quarterback, and then just be efficient on offense and play smart. So, you know, it's going to be a great challenge. And I think, you know, it's good to see Moorhead that, you know, getting to this game and improving their program. And from when I was there, whatever it was, 10 years ago or whatever, it's an exciting time for me to see that get to this game, and then us to get to this game, and so it should be fun. Should be an exciting game.
Well, good luck, coach, and have fun out there and stay warm.
Yeah, thank you. Absolutely.
We are here at Dragons Live pregame show coverage of the Mineral Water Bowl. You just heard from Coach Fenwick. Now let's hear what head coach Steve Lockway had to say about his Dragons today. Joined here by head football coach Steve Lockway. Coach, we are here in Excelsior Springs for the Mineral Water Bowl, and you guys are playing S&T today. It is a big, exciting day. It's taken a lot of preparation, but what does it mean for you and your football program in the university to play in a game like this?
Well, it's been a long run over the last 8 years of kind of building the program and getting our culture, you know, where we want it. And this is kind of the next step for us. It's a great venue. It's been a great atmosphere for our kids. I think it's been one of those milestones that a whole bunch of alumni that have wanted to see happen. And so we finally got to that day. The day's here, and hopefully we can enjoy it and have a good day.
Now, between the St. Cloud win, when you knew you were in to play this game, and today, a lot of time has passed, several weeks. What has preparation been like for you and your team to get ready for today?
Well, it's been some preparing for the future. We took great advantage of the time, allowed our red shirts to get some good work. You know, then obviously you get into this bowl preparation. When you have a whole 3 weeks, you can do a lot of game planning, which means you got to be ready for a lot of things because you know they're doing the same thing. And so I think the chess pieces are going to be moving a lot today, faster pace than normal because of the prep time, and so I think early adjustments are going to be huge from that standpoint.
And it's a little bit of weather, a little bit of overcast today. It's going to be a tough game, and we know nothing about S&T. What are the keys to victory today for Dragons football?
Well, I'll tell you, it's a lot better than negative below zero wind chill when we've been practicing in. So obviously keys today for us, we got to get out to a fast start. As I said before, the chess pieces are going to be moving. So starting well offensively and defensively, I think, is huge, is to get the crowd into the game, to get, you know, our feet under our guys, to get some confidence, because it has been a long layoff. And so it feels kind of like the first game of the year. So start is huge. They're an explosive offense. They're up-tempo. They're wide open. They're spread. Their skill kids are dynamic, and so our defense is going to have to limit the big plays. If we can keep them from making big plays, we got a shot to win. And I think three, offensively, we've got to find a way to get our playmakers the ball in space. I think our advantage is on our skill kids on the perimeter. We got to be able to protect the ball, protect our quarterback. These guys are top five in the country in sacks, and so if we can do that, get the ball in space, I like our chances. We got a good shot to win.
Well, good luck today, coach, and hopefully come out with that big W. You just heard it from head coach Steve Lockway about our Dragon football program, what this means, and how big today is for all of them as you see Tiger Stadium here in Excelsior Springs, Missouri. I want to thank you thoroughly for joining us on the Dragons Live pregame show. And I want to thank all of our sponsors who helped make this happen. I want to thank Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, Sodexo, Affinity Plus Federal Credit Union, Missouri S&T, Buffalo Wild Wings, the NSIC, our television partner, WDAY, and of course, MSUM, and all of our crew. It was a long drive down, and we really appreciate you watching it, all the hard work that's going to come out today. Enjoy the game, have fun, and of course, go Dragons!